Good evening and welcome to Christ the King for our worship tonight. We're coming to you live from this not so big room, choir room, and we're glad that you joined us for worship today. We want to thank all those people who showed up on Saturday in the morning for cinnamon and caramel rolls for our youth fundraiser. Our kids sold 664, is that right? They would add 65, but I had the 65 one. So thank you for coming to that. And also, for all those that showed out on Sunday when it was very cold to drop off your commitment cards, we appreciate that. In fact, if you have not dropped those off, I have them here. They look like this. Okay, one is a one-year commitment for the church, and the other is a three-year commitment for the building. You can drop them off in our secure mailbox or come by. Let us know if you're coming by. You can call Jan at the church. But we need those cards and we appreciate it. Some of you, if you're on Facebook and you're pretty handy at Facebook, you can scroll down and you can see an announcement we have that's coming up this weekend. We are trying to make friends with the neighborhood church over in the Madison area, as you know. And they have an opportunity that you can come on Saturday or Sunday or both, right, Scott, and help them fix a meal, prepare meals in boxes that they can get out. They're going to do 100 meals to that neighborhood, and if you're looking for something that is really worthwhile, we encourage you to sign up right there on Facebook when you scroll down to that. And as a reminder, as you can see on your computer, all the lyrics to tonight's music are also printed there. We are having Advent coming up here in a couple weeks, and I wanted to remind you that, you remember when you were a kid and you had the little Advent calendars, you ever have those? Well, we're doing that virtually, and so we will have a little two-minute video clips on Facebook, on our webpage. Every day they'll be different, and they're on different topics, patience, kindness, certain things like that. So maybe you can relive your childhood by opening those. We also have a special guest with us today, Pastor John Olson. Comes to us all the way from Lake Wobegon, Lake Long Lake, is that where? One of the Long Lakes in Minnesota. So he's come with us, and he's been helping us on our capital campaign, and he's going to share a message with us tonight. So I think those are announcements. So I'm going to ask you if you'd join us for worship tonight. Let us worship together. If we can't be together, at least we can be together in spirit as we celebrate the goodness of God. During these times of uncertainty, let us walk towards the future, walking with the one that gives us life and opportunities to love our neighbors. Come join the journey of Jesus today. And the peace of the Lord be with you.
And also
with you. And share the peace of the Lord. We'll do peace signs here at church. You can hug your family if that's what you do, or you can come up with something. But the peace of the Lord be with you. We are going to sing For God's Love forever. And as we begin our worship today, we bow down before God and we admit our sinful nature. And we're going to do that in the form of a prayer, a confession of prayer tonight. And I'd ask you, if you want to assume an attitude of prayer, you can close your eyes. Some people like to kneel. I know somebody that lays on the floor. I won't say who they are. But we want you to join us in this prayer of confession. Let us pray. Gracious Lord God, as we approach the coming of your Son, the Christ child, during this year that has seemed hopeless and filled with despair, as we have been rocked by a disease which has threatened our lives and our livelihoods, we admit to you, Lord, that our trust in you has waned and that we have been ready to give up. Forgive us, O Lord. We pray that we would be able to see your signs of mercy breaking into our lives and into the world. Challenge us, Lord, to be not to be indifferent to the evils that are around us, nor mask our pain with tinsel and glitter. Lord, empower us by clearing up our clutter, the clutter that is in our lives, and make welcome for you, a place for you to enter our lives. Have mercy upon us, Lord, for you are the Holy One. Amen. I want you to hear this good news for you. It's through the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ that you have been redeemed. And because of that, you are an accepted, forgiven, and loved child of God. Repeat after me. I am an accepted, forgiven, and loved child of God.
Love child of God.
I am an accepted, forgiven, and loved child of God.
I am an accepted, forgiven,
and loved child of God.
Love child of God.
Let's sing another song about our awesome God. How about that?
I love it. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh God, is it awesome God?
Let us pray. Gracious Lord God, you are the creator of all living things, and you have entrusted us to care for and watch over all of your creation. Rekindle in us the desire to share your goodness with all the world, with our time, our talents, and our possessions. We pray these things through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen. Our reading for tonight's worship comes from 2 Corinthians, from the Apostle Paul. And he says this. Paul says, "The point is this, that one who sows sparingly will reap sparingly, and the one who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each of you must give as you have made up your mind, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver, and God is able to provide you with every blessing in abundance, so that by always having enough of everything, you may share abundantly in every good work." Here ends our reading.
'Well, I want to extend a warm welcome to all of you, and before I begin this evening's message, I want to say a word of thanks to your worship band. I have watched them on many, many Wednesday nights the last couple months, or few months, and they do such a fantastic job, and I know it's a real odd thing to be leading worship to two people in person, but you have all those folks online who are watching, and I was one of them. I am one of them, and I want to personally thank you for the wonderful work and ministry that you do here at Christ the King. So thank you.
You are so welcome.
And dear friends in Christ, grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'll be sharing some thoughts this evening on a short verse from the book of Hebrews, chapter 13, verse 8. The author writes, "Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever." So, if you're just tuning into this online worship, you've noticed that I am not Pastor Jamie and I am not Deacon Jess. My name is Pastor John Olson, and I've had the joy of working with your congregation the past few months on your Reunited in Joy stewardship program. I should add, it's been a real pleasure to work the last few months with Christ the King on this stewardship appeal, especially with the leadership of your congregation. As you already know, you have a very gifted staff and you have many gifted lay leaders here at Christ the King. It's been a real blessing to work closely with Pastor Jamie and Jody, who's running the camera tonight, and Deacon Jess and Jan in the office, and also to work with your campaign chairs, Caleb Somm and Skip Klinkhammer, and all the other members of the Reunited and Joy leadership team. What a great group. I want to publicly thank them again for all the time and energy they put into this special stewardship appeal. And hopefully you know about it by now, you know all about it. Reunited and Joy is the program your congregation set up to address the mortgage debt of $1.6 million. There is a main goal of $500,000 and a challenge goal of $600,000 to be given over the next 3 years to make the mortgage payments and save a whole lot of money on the interest over the course of the loan. You've been generous before, and we hope that you'll be generous again. Paying down the loan is crucial to the future of this congregation, so every gift, small and large, is important. Freed up from the burden of this debt, Christ the King will be able to explore all kinds of new ministries. Just think about it. For children, for youth, for families, for seniors. Freed up from the burden of this debt, Christ the King will be able to explore new ways to share the good news of Christ. And that's why this campaign is so important. Here's how I think of it. When my twin daughters were very young, their mother and I were diligent about teaching them their address and their phone number. Like many parents, we were worried about what might happen if our kids were lost, or, God forbid, if they were taken from us. We wanted them to know their address and phone number, so if anything ever happened to them, they could tell someone where they lived and who to call so they could get back safely home. So over and over again, we had them repeat their address, Rural Route 6, Box 154, Fergus Falls. And over and over again, we had them repeat their phone number, 736-4680. Well, you can imagine, it didn't take them long to memorize the information. And we stressed to them how important it was to know these things. And we stressed that this information would never change. This would be their address and this would be their phone number. And if anything ever happened to them in the future, this is the information they'd need. Well, you might imagine that our intentions were good, but sadly, it's not how things worked out. About a year after we moved into our house on the outskirts of Fergus Falls, we received a letter informing us that new 911 emergency addresses were replacing the rural route addresses in Ottertail County. In essence, our address would no longer be Rural Route 6, Box 154. Instead, we'd be living at 21396 250th Street. Same house, new address. We sat down with our daughters and we explained that one of the things we thought would never change had indeed changed. But that wasn't all. About a year after the new address, we decided to drop our landline and to get cell phones instead. And no longer would our phone number be 218-736-4680. Instead, we had two new cell phones with two new phone numbers. Once again, we sat down with our daughters and explained that one of the things we thought would never change had indeed changed. Well, looking back, we probably shouldn't have told our young daughters that their address and phone numbers would never change. Because as most of us know, life is full of changes, and things rarely stay the same. Right now, I think we're all too aware of this. These days, we're surrounded by constant change. Every single day, nothing staying the same. Our weather has certainly changed. Burr, if you were here on Sunday to drop off commitment cards, there were some of us in the parking lot that got a little cold. Right, Pastor Jamie?
Yeah.
We're missing those warm days of summer already. And then, what about the 2020 elections? They have brought change at local, state, and national levels. And then we have COVID-19. The pandemic has brought change to our everyday lives in ways we couldn't have even imagined back in January and February. Almost every aspect of our lives has been affected by the pandemic. Our schools, our work, our shopping, our entertainment, our gatherings, our holidays, and even our churches. Nothing's the same right now. The last few months have been a whirl of change, and not all of them good. Maybe that's why we can appreciate today's scripture so much. The reading from Hebrews, reminding us that in the midst of a sea of change, one thing remains constant. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. That hasn't changed. The grace of God, the love of God, the forgiveness of God, the good news of the resurrection to eternal life that comes through Christ, none of that has changed. Nor has the mission of the church as we make every effort to share this good news with a world hungering to hear it. You know, one of the things we've learned throughout these months of the pandemic is that we can find new ways to carry out the mission of the church if we need to. We can do online worship. We can do online Christian education. We can meet using Zoom. And we can use social media to connect with each other. We've discovered that we can adapt and continue to share the love of Christ in lots of new ways. These last few months, though, we've also discovered that we really miss being together in person. The things we do online are good and they're okay, but they don't replace our in-person gatherings. The truth is, we miss sitting next to our church family in the pews on a Sunday or a Wednesday. We miss singing and praying together. We miss sharing Holy Communion in person. We miss the informal conversations in the narthex or the recs before or after worship. We miss the handshakes and the hugs. We miss sitting at a table in the church building and sharing a cup of coffee or a meal. We miss seeing children coming out of their classrooms, smiling and laughing, excited to tell their parents what they learned during faith walk. We miss studying scripture together. We miss gathering together for a funeral to support the ones who are grieving. We miss celebrating the joy of a baptism and the opportunity to warmly welcome the newly baptized into God's family. The truth is, there's so much that happens in a church building. The church building really is the center of mission for a community of faith. And again, that's why reunited in joy is so important to Christ the King. One day, the changes brought about by the pandemic will come to an end, and communities of faith will safely return to their church buildings. You'll be in this space once again. This is where the choir rehearses, correct? Mm-hmm. And you'll be in the sanctuary. You'll be in the recs, fellowship hall, the narthex, greeting, seeing old friends. You'll be in this space once again. And this space will once more be the center of mission for worship and education, and fellowship and service. Your gifts to Reunited in Joy and to the General Fund will continue to support all the good ministry that's taking place here now, and also will support the good ministry that will take place through Christ the King in the future. The good news of Christ will be shared in all kinds of ways. Lives will be changed. And it's your generosity that helps make that happen. You see, as we live in this time of immense change, the good news of Christ becomes ever more important. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. The message of Christ's love and grace and forgiveness never changes. Your generosity ensures this message of good news continues to provide stability and hope in this ever-changing world. So thank you for generously supporting the mission God has set before this congregation. Small or large, whatever gifts you give, they are appreciated. And we're grateful that you're a partner in this important work. Amen.
Thank you. We do something called an affirmation of faith during worship, and it is what we believe as Christians. And it really boils down to God has been revealed as God the Father, Creator, as Son Jesus, and as the Holy Spirit. And we usually do an Apostles' Creed, but I'm going to read a different one for you tonight. And so just listen to the words. As we affirm how our faith goes in the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We believe in God the Father, the creator of all living things, the one who gave us dominion over the earth, and whom we promised to care for creation so we all might live in harmony with our God. And we believe in Christ Jesus, who walks with us into real life each day. He was both human and divine. Christ experienced all that this life had to offer, both the pain and the suffering, as well as the joy of the life. He suffered and died for us on a cross, and in 3 days he rose again, and today the love of Christ continues to bring new life to us and to the world. And we believe in the Holy Spirit, who is the very breath of God. She blows in and through us, enabling us, the body of Christ, to bring God's life and light to our neighbors, empowering us to be disciples of Jesus. And so we believe in God, the three in one, who continues to give us opportunities to know Christ and to make Christ known. Amen. And now together I ask you to join me in prayer. Again, assume an attitude of prayer as we pray the prayers of the people, the prayers from our congregation in the world. Let us pray. Gracious Lord God, we pray for this place we call Christ the King, for all the people that come in and out of our doors. We pray that someday we would be able to be together again. We ask, Lord, that your Spirit would cross the boundaries of the visual world and the virtual one, and that we would be able to feel each other's presence, our presence praying for each other, for all those who are in need, and for all those who we love. And we pray, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious God, we thank you and we stand in awe of your creation. For those parts of creation where we have abandoned or we have misused, we ask for your forgiveness. We ask that you bless this earth that you've given us to care for. And as the air is filled with a pandemic that is threatening us, we ask, Lord, for your winds to blow, your healing winds, so that once again we may greet and live the life that you prepared for us. We pray, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious Lord God, we pray for the leaders locally and across the world who make decisions for us. We ask that you would have them see the vulnerability of people who they serve, that they would not only look at those who are powerful or influential, but that they would see those who are weak and those who are needy and those who are on the margins, and cooperate with all those that are helping to serve them. We pray, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And gracious God, we cry out to you through our distress. We pray for those people who have COVID, for those people who are at home having to isolate themselves. We also pray for those who have died. We ask, Lord, that you would be with their families as they suffer through that. We pray for those who are having surgery, and we give thanks to you for those who had successful surgery and now are at home recuperating. We pray especially for Barb. We ask, Lord, that you would be with all of us in the depths of our pain and suffering. We pray, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And gracious God, we give you thanks. We ask that you would stir up in us this restlessness that we've had, and to extend our love to those people that are in the margins, those people that we no longer see in person, but we know that need your help and your love. We pray for our families. We pray for the family of Christ the King. And for all those whom we love, we pray, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. It is into your hands, O Lord, that we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Thank you. We prepare for the coming of our King, the King who came in the form of an infant. Let me remind you tonight that it was in the night in which he was betrayed that our Lord took bread, and he gave thanks, and he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I invite you at home. This would be the time where you get your bread and wine or grape juice, and you can join us. The body of Christ broken for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you. And may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Before I give the benediction, we have one person who sits out here. Her name's Jody, and she's our youth director. And you want to come up here, and I'll give you some time since you've been giving us all your time.
Hello. I know Jamie already mentioned the extreme gratitude that we have for all the cinnamon rolls that we sold. You surpassed our expectations by at least 64 roles, if not more, because we thought Andy overshot. So thank you very much. And if you are joining our drive-throughs on December 11th from 4 to 7, we will be serving take and bake pizzas. We prefer if you order ahead, but you can also order as you drive up. So put that on your calendars, December 11th, 4 to 7, and come and get some take and bake pizzas. Thanks, guys.
And we just want to thank you for all the support that you've given us during this difficult time. And I echo what Jody said. Thank you, Christ the King members, and all those other people that are watching us. Let me give you a special blessing before we go. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Thanks for joining us. See you guys.